Hello everyone, SMA Watts here, and we are in round four of a player ran modern event. This is a keepable hand. Especially when your opponent mulligans. Well, let's see, what are you playing? Well, there aren't a lot of black cleaved decks that this is, Oh, well, that's not a phenomenal turn to play against. Nope, not what I thought. I was thinking burn. That's a goif. The mighty 01 goif. Alright, what are you playing? Terminate. You get a 1/2 Goyf. Such incidental value of, So, Jund removal spells that can actually kill Fiendslayer Paladin are none? Do they have one? I mean, theoretically, Liliana can. Abrupt Decay it. Well, it finally made his Goyf a 2/3. All right, I'll race you. Your own? Oh, scavenging news. All right. I mean, Jund is. Not a matchup I've actually done much with this, to be honest. Like, my instincts tell me Jund's probably a pretty okay matchup. Like, at worst, 40-60. But possibly it depends. But I'd say it vacillates between 60-40 and 40-60, depending entirely on the makeup of the decks. Alright, so he's scavenging ooze, eating my other creature. Terminate removing my Flicker Wisp. So he can attack for 5. I mean, I'm not sure if there was something in 4 mana. Do they even play anything in 4 mana anymore? I mean, maybe Thrun? I did potentially open up Thrun. That doesn't look like Thrun. Huntmaster. Alright, well, Huntmaster does stabilize him pretty well. Amp, he gets to flip it. Ooh, nasty combination. Also nasty for me to not. Like, I have out still, but I need to actually draw them. Alright. I don't know how many forests he plays, so.
Wow.
Yeah. I should have passed the scavenger news. I don't know what I was thinking. That would have been helpful a couple turns ago. Yeah, I think I'm just dead. In fact, I actually know I'm just dead. Well, much more dead than I thought I was. But boy, was I dead. All right, so against Jund, and we bring in our guys that are hard to remove. Do I want to bring in Rest in Peace? Thalia's not phenomenal against them. Actually, I don't think Fiend Hunter. Well, no, Fiend Hunter's actually pretty good against them. Even if they remove it, a lot of their creatures, like a couple of their creatures, get worse when you start jiggering with them. But some of them get better. Yeah, we're actually going to keep the Fiend Hunter out. Yeah, that was just a matter of, for some reason I was thinking Tarmogoyf was a bigger threat than Scavenging Ooze when, I don't know why I was thinking that. Scavenging Ooze is really hard to deal with. It's a keeper. Inquisition. Okay, well, you take. Well, this will actually be very interesting. So he only has two options. And he takes the creature. Well, hopefully he doesn't have another one. I mean, this creature is really hard for them to remove, though, actually. So I guess there is something dead for. Come on. Well, he's casting lightning bolts this whole turn. think he was hoping I would path it to get him a land. Because this is a brutal board state. So I'm thinking he's holding Abrupt Decay. Because if he had a Lightning Bolt, you already use it. End of my turn, you just bolt this guy. Or Thalia, one of the two. If you're holding Abrupt Decay, the only thing you can hit with it is Thalia, which isn't really going to get the job done. Yep. But it opens you up to play Liliana next turn. That was dumb. And that, yeah, you want this one to go on the stack first, so it puts the tokens. And just dead. Wow. Didn't quite realize it was that much of a, and you lose. Hadn't done the math there. Fact that, yeah, that is 13. How good is this hand if, well, this hand's terrible if I don't draw another land. I've till turn three to draw a second white source. I think it's okay though if I do. And Rumbling Ravine's not the most threatening thing against me. Land or a 2-drop? That's neither. Yeah, I think, depending on what he plays here, we could be in a lot of trouble. Planes. Whew. Got there. So this is Liliana. No? Alright, what is this? Huntmaster. Beatings. So yeah, we play our sword. Oh, I should have attacked. Might have tried to double block and I could have pathed it. This is Liliana. I'm in deep trouble. Does not seem to be. Okay, well, that's a good answer for sword. All right, now it's spells. So the Huntmaster can kill them. And he's like, I really should have done that first. I think you take hero, because really, you're not gonna... And I'm going to tank the land because I gain very little by playing it, but I keep him not knowing what I have by not playing it. He's casting something. I have no idea what it is. Red, green, maybe Maelstrom Pulse? There's two red. And a black. Volcanic Anger of the Anger of the Beating. Okay, yeah, that was bad. That more or less derailed my entire plan. Alright, yeah, might as well go all in at this point. If he has a second anger, I'm dead. There's a lot of man lands. Lightning Bolt. Bob. I'd be a little shaky on Bob at this point. Dark Confidant revealing Dark Confidant. That's like the worst card to reveal in this type of position, because I don't think you really want two on the table. All right, Lily. Is he going to try and tick her up to ultimate? Nope. I'd have actually held Bob back there. Playing the second one. That's spicy. All right. Corrupt Decay. Liliana. All right. He pitched an Inquisition, so he has an Abrupt Decay and a Liliana in his hand. I got lots of life. Nope. Killed his own Bob. Got lucky. Corsair of Krufex is a pretty good counterweight to Dark Confidant. So I need to draw. Actually, there's pretty much nothing I can draw that's actually super good. Kitchen Finks, I guess. Path is pretty good. Is he deciding whether or not to shuffle? And he did not. He wanted to draw his Tarmogoyf, because it's a big Tarmogoyf. And he could certainly play Liliana and force himself to sack a creature. God, it's a big Tarmogoyf. My chance of his Dark Confidant killing him is going way down. And I haven't drawn gas in quite a while. Yeah, but he's getting rid of his own. That would have been a great place to have another path, though. Or a dismember. I'm like, wah, wah. Alright, well, I haven't seen a card that's useful for the situation in, like, since he played Dark Confidant almost. Like, that Maelstrom Pulse for my sword was a beating. Whatever. Unless you have a lightning bolt in your hand, it doesn't actually change your clock. Just reminds you of the fact that I'm dead no matter what. Yeah, I'll discard my Aether Vial, huh. Alright, Dryad Militant, you are not good enough anymore. And that is game. Good game. Look, I'm pretty sure that that's not a terrible matchup. I don't know if it's actually a favorable matchup or not. I think after sideboarding, I think we have a slight advantage, but I'm really not sure. And it's one of those things of, even if you have a favorable matchup against Jund, they have so many powerful cards that they can just sometimes go runner, like, just ridiculous card after ridiculous card that just buries you in incremental advantage. I mean, it's what the deck's designed to do. So, yeah. I mean, the fact that we didn't see a lot of... How many creatures do we actually see? I didn't think of Anger of the Gods when he played it. If I'd thought of Anger of the Gods, I would not have put more creatures out, and I would not have just thrown away at Kitchen Finks. But that was what killed us there.